Hello, I'm Professor Von Schmohawk, and welcome to Why You. In the last lecture, we saw how systems of two linear equations and two variables could be solved using the elimination method to find one solution which simultaneously satisfies both equations. The solution is represented graphically by the point where the graphs of the two equations intersect. As we saw, the elimination method involves adding the equations in the system to produce a new equation that eliminates one of the variables. The justification usually given for this process is that since it is okay to add the same thing to both sides of an equation, then two equations can be added. Since both sides of the second equation are equal and are therefore the same thing. However, this does not tell the whole story, since adding two equations leads to an equation whose graph is different from either of the original equations. In this lecture, we will more closely examine what happens when two equations are added and why this procedure works for the elimination method. The process of adding two equations is simple. We just line up like terms and add them. For instance, in this system, we add the x terms, the y terms, and the constant terms to produce a new equation. But what is the significance of this new equation? And what mathematical relationship does it have to the two equations of the system? If we graph all three equations, we see that the graph of the new equation has only one point in common with the two equations which were added. All three equations intersect at this same point. When adding two equations, the solutions of the equation which is produced are generally different from the solutions of either equation in the system, and so its graph will be different as well. However, the new equation will always share the one solution which is common to both equations of the system. We can prove this will always happen when any two equations are added by showing that this is true in a general case. When we simultaneously graph two equations, at any point of intersection, both equations are satisfied. Let's call the two equations of this system equation A and equation B. And let's call the expressions on either side of these equations expressions A1 and A2 and B1 and B2. Now let's add equations A and B to produce a new equation. Since the intersection point of the graphs represents the point at which equations A and B are both satisfied, at that point, both expressions in equation A have the same value, and both expressions in equation B have the same value. So at that point, both sides of the new equation have the same value, and that equation will also be satisfied. Since all three equations are satisfied at that intersection point, that point is included in all three equations' graphs. And all three graphs will pass through the same intersection point. So, when two equations are added, the resulting equation's graph must pass through the intersection point of the two original equations. However, when using the elimination method, it is sometimes necessary to multiply one or both equations by constants before they are added. But after multiplying by constants, will the graph of the resulting equation still pass to the original intersection point? To find out, let's start with equations A and B and multiply equation A by a constant, which we will call small a, and equation B by a constant small b. We know that multiplying both sides of an equation by a non-zero constant does not change its solutions or graph. So the graphs of both equations will remain unchanged, and they will still intersect at the same point as before. Now let's add the two equations. Since at the intersection point, equations A and B are both satisfied, at that point, both expressions in equation A have the same value, and both expressions in equation B have the same value. So both sides of the new equation have the same value, and that equation will also be satisfied. Once again, all three graphs must pass through the same intersection point. As we have just shown, multiplying the equations by constants before they are added maintains the original point of intersection, and the graph of the new equation will still share this common solution. But other than passing through this point, what effect does this have on the rest of the resulting equation's graph? At the beginning of this lecture, we added the equations 3x minus y equals 3 and x minus y equals negative 1, producing the equation 4x minus 2y equals 2, whose graph passes between the two original lines. But let's say that before adding the equations in this system, we multiply both sides of the bottom equation by negative 2. Now, when we add the equations, we get x plus y equals 5. Although, as we saw, this equation's graph must still pass through the intersection point of the two lines of the system, it now has a different slope than before. Now, let's see what happens if, in addition to multiplying the bottom equation by negative 2, we multiply the top equation by positive 2. When we add the equations, we get 4x plus 0 equals 8, or 4x equals 8, which can be written more simply as x equals 2. Just as before, this equation's graph passes through the intersection point of the original two lines, but now the resulting line is vertical. This equation is especially informative, since it tells us that the x-coordinate of the intersection point is 2. Likewise, if we take the original equations and multiply the bottom equation by negative 3, when we add the equations, we get 0 plus 2y equals 6, or 2y equals 6, which we can write more simply as y equals 3. Once again, this equation's graph passes through the intersection point of the original two lines, but now the resulting line is horizontal. This equation tells us that the y-coordinate of the intersection point is 3. By choosing various multipliers before adding the two equations, we can produce a new line with any orientation we like. However, no matter which multipliers we choose, the resulting line will always cross the two original lines at their intersection point, and thus share the solution common to the two original equations. To find the coordinates of the intersection point of two lines, we choose multipliers for the equations that will cause the line produced by adding them to be either vertical or horizontal. The equation of this line then tells us the intersection point's x-coordinate or y-coordinate. This is the basis for solving a system of equations using the elimination method. So far, we have seen how the graphs of two linear equations can intersect at a single point and thus share a common solution. In the next lecture, we will examine other relationships which can occur between two linear equations which do not share a single common solution.